This girl is an actress. Born in Toronto, could become an international star. She lives not in Canada, but Hampstead, England. Studied at RADA and became a star pupil. Worked the chorus of Guys and Dolls. Had a major part in the television film A Month in the Country. Her name? Thorson. Linda Thorson.
The original name was Berg Thorson, which is of old Icelandic extraction, but I cut off the Berg and left the Thorson, because no one could ever remember Berg Thorson.
Have you got some awards, I believe, or what were they?
Yes, an honours diploma as opposed to a level diploma, and a prize for best student in voice production, and a singing scholarship, which you get free singing lessons for the whole time you're there.
Mm-hmm. So what can you sing? What sort of
things? Well, originally sort of high soprano, but I got training so I can sing everything, jazz or pop.
What have you done since you left RADA?
Right after I left, I was very lucky because Susanna York saw me and asked me to play Vera in Month and Country, which they were doing as a sort of home production at her summer home or country estate, you know. And then some American people saw it and liked it and backed up making a film of it, which has gone to be shown on American television. First word I heard of them, TV. Word was impossible, and it was for a toilet paper ad actually, and they wrapped us all up in loo paper, in pink with all flowers all over it, so that they looked like long sari dresses, you know, and then they said this is the sort of thing you can do with our super new loo paper, and we just said impossible.
Linda Thorson, 10 take 3.
I love your hands.
Oh, they're nothing to sing about. Red and not at all smooth.
But gentle.
I suppose your wife's hands are soft.
She does work with them.
But not scrubbing and cleaning and such.
No, not that.
Your hands are like a woman. Jim's hands are the roughest I've ever seen.
You never mentioned it before?
No.
You loved him very much, didn't you?
Oh, I.
Elizabeth and I, I was very fond of her. We liked the same things. But now the real thing's caught up with me.
Any memories of Russia particularly?
Yes, went particularly, which is nice because most people don't ever go there. So I went all over Russia with a tour from Cambridge. We started off and went through Germany and Czechoslovakia. Then we went to Russia, went to Kiev, Moscow, Leningrad, back through Warsaw to Germany, to East and West Berlin. It's lovely. Moscow, I was eating in one of these great big tents and I had my handbag beside me on a chair and I looked around and it was gone and it had been stolen, all my money and my passport and everything was gone and I was with the group and the group was leaving that night to go to Leningrad and I was detained and kept in a little room because they couldn't find my passport and they thought it was all very strange and they found the handbag with nothing in it but the passport, which is again very strange because they usually think that's what the people want so that they can say that they're you and get out of the country and defect, you know, but it was there. And then afterwards everybody was super to me, of course, because they didn't want me to sort of say life's rotten in Russia, you know. And I went off and joined the group to go to America to do rep for a year with John Fernald, who used to be the principal of RADA, and left through changes of opinion and things. And he started a super theatre in a place near Detroit, which is doing very, very well.
Real.
What I feel for you is real.
You'll forget about me soon enough.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
You know, most of the time when I'm with you, I feel much older than you are.
I'm not surprised. You make me feel 20 again.
What is it you want from a woman, then? Mothering.
More than that.
Is that horse? Well, I don't like to say he's rotten now, because when I first got on, he was rotten and ran away with me all over Hyde Park. But after I got to told him that I meant business, he was all right. And I liked him in the end.
How long have you been swimming?
Well, I started swimming when I was about 3, because we had a summer cottage. We used to go up there and get nasty floats when we were little, and finally got out of them and learned to swim.
How did you get on with Susanna York and who else was it?
Ian McShane, lovely Ian McShane. Got along with him very, very well, because he's a sort of method thing where he keeps attitude on stage the same as off stage, and little Vera was mad about him and he wasn't mad about Vera, and so he was very rude to me all the time and the scenes came off splendidly.
Much, much more.
Doesn't your wife give it to you?
It's not so much who gives it, it's who you want it from. Oh, why does everything have to be so complicated? I wish it were different, darling.
It's all right, love. I know what I'm doing.
But it'll be hard, you know that. It'll mean lies and deceit and subterfuge. And no one else will ever see it as we do.
You know, you worry too much about what other people say.